Hello everyone, I am Atya and I am here to make a gameplay critique of DjTinnio. He sent me a link to his new gameplay on Discord in private message, and it was because he stated before his bad performance in the game was only because he had a very bad PC setup and he had very low FPS all the time. And now he has got the i7 CPU and the 2018 Ti GPU from Nvidia, which are pretty much the best stuffs on the market. So let's see, was he right or not? So it looks like this is a Walker Assault game on the Twilight and Hot. It is a very, very open, large map, so let's see what you are going to use. I can see you are on the rebel side, which is always a disadvantage. So you are running with jetpack, cooling cell, cycler, E3 and berserker. Jetpack is obviously a good choice, and I can see you are using the melee button for interacting, which is not a good idea because there are cases when, for example, you need to activate, you need to interact something, and at the same time you should be shooting at your enemy to not die, and while you are doing a melee animation you are not able to shoot consistently, so that can be a disadvantage. But you activated the uplink, so that was good, and your trait started boosting up. In my opinion, the cooling cell is not a good choice, especially not for E3, because basically when you need to activate the cooling cell after your 6 or 7 bursts, when you're almost overheated, you should go back to cover instead of popping out your head still and taking the risk you will getting shattered. I think you could have zoomed in. That cooling set was unnecessary. Cyclone rifle is not very good against ATSTs, and what I would have done in your place, so here you get the power up, that's okay, you can see the ATST. The first thing what I would have done is definitely not engaging it, because it will look at you and it will wipe you out basically in a matter of seconds. So you jetpacked away, which is good. Right into the squad shield, which is also good. Maybe I would have used my card refresh, because all your star cards are on cooldown. You come out and you die by the ATST, but if you would have used your card refresh you could have jumped up there, and I think you would have been safe. I don't know why didn't your partner spawn. It looked like your partner was in quite safe place and you spawned far behind him. Yeah, if he's looking at the objective, scamping, but quite safe. So I don't know why didn't you spawn on him. And now you have used your card refresh, which was unnecessary also, because you have got a normal spawn, and you need a pretty much amount of time to go back in action, and where you actually need the star cards. I don't know what you are doing here. Either. And that was an unnecessary jetpack. Okay, there is a droid somewhere, you can use your cycler to hunt it down. Okay, you can spot the droid, it just killed your teammate. Never mind, you're taking the high ground, that's also good. It was a nice shot. Okay, good, you finished him off. You get another kill, good. And you are dropping down when you are... And you should have been aware of that droid is still there. Because it was just shooting at your teammate 10 seconds ago. Okay, good. That was a standing still enemy. You can give him an easy headshot. Okay, good. You surprised him. That was an unnecessary jetpack totally, because as you can see here, if you jetpack, if you use a jetpack, especially without jumping before using jetpack, you will end up stating like here, in a very open area without any cover, and maybe if you run there and you are getting shotted from the sniper snap here or somewhere, you can use a jetpack to run away or escape back. But here now you cannot escape really. Should have zoomed in my opinion. Okay, good, you used your jetpack to escape, that was nice. That cooling cell was absolutely unnecessary. Your enemy has popped up here just a few seconds ago, and in my opinion you should have noticed that in time. Like here, you're shooting and already your enemy is popping up here and engaging you. That jetpack was unnecessary again. But fortunately it doesn't have a long cooldown. Okay, that was a good place for a proxy mine. You will definitely get a kill with it. Nice shot. Okay, good. That jetpack was also unnecessary. You could have just ran forward and take a little bit more amount of damage, but your health could have regenerated easily before engaging another enemy. That jetpack was also unnecessary. Okay, watch the radar. Where are the enemies? Okay, you know you are... You know your enemies are nearby you, so you start walking, that's good. I think you were too slow, and you basically couldn't have killed that guy with cycler, only with headshot, and that couldn't have been easy, so I think you should have tried to engage that guy with an E3, especially have berserk and hip fire in that close range. That would have been a smarter choice. Okay, good, you are taking the high ground, that's good. Oh, nice shot. Okay, that was a good tracking and nice rapid fire. Wasting some time here, that was an unnecessary jetpack, you could have just jumped right down. Okay, fine, you used the smart racket to... Use your smart racket to damage the walker, but in my opinion, if I am playing in a large game mode where there are a bunch of vehicles, and especially if I am on the rebel side, I rather like to... hold my rockets and disruptor rifles to the ATSTs, because basically those are the only things that are efficient against the tanks, and you use your cooling set too early, in my opinion. You could have shot like 7 or 8 bursts, overheat your gun, and right after that you pop the cooling cell, and you can shot even more. Rapid fire is not bad here, but not really flawless. Like, no, you should have used your cooling cell, in my opinion. Especially, no one was engaging you when you were shooting at the walker, but I don't understand why did you decide to turn this way. So you turn this way, okay? And you can see you are getting shot from your left. But you turn here, not really the right direction. And you're looking for your enemies here. Still, I don't know why. I'm not sure at what were you looking at here. Because if you check the radar, the snipers are probably up here or are going down here. And if you watch your radar, the red is much more visible on your left, so you definitely should have turned left, especially because you can see these little points. It means your enemies are in the canyons or something. Again, you didn't spawn on your partner, I don't know why. In my totally honest opinion, the good players, or at least what we in the competitive community call good players, don't ever use air vehicles. Okay, that was a good kill, but your enemy was like half HP or less. You're trying to do a safe run, but you could hit nothing, it looks like. And now you're trying to escape when you are like 70 health. Not so brave move, but okay. And I am not entirely sure what you're doing here. You missed too many shots there, in my opinion.
Gute Arbeit. Wir haben den Uplink aktiviert.
And now you decided to escape, okay? I guess you were trying to jetpack up, but you wasted it, and just like your cycler, but doesn't really matter because both of them has a short jet time. And don't know why are you playing in first person now. That was an unnecessary jetpack, because walking down here is very very dangerous because your enemies are spawning behind the cliffs, and if they are coming this way they just low down, spot you, you are completely out of cover, they will defeat you easily. But in this case obviously it is not going to happen because your enemies are a bit far away. That was a good racket on Bosk. But you missed too many shots, and now you should have used your cooling cell to finish him off. And I guess you wouldn't have died there if you did that. Again, unnecessary cooling cell. Okay, that was a good kill.
Station wurde aktiviert.
Alright. At least I learned today something.
Wir haben die Uplink-Station aktiviert. Gute Arbeit.
You don't always jump in after a rolling, which is not so effective. It makes the rolling not so effective because you cannot go so far away without jumping. I think you're too defensive now. You're basically standing on your spawn point. You could have moved forward. Okay, good, you are doing that. But you are still hesitating too much. You're checking the radar. Your enemies are either up here. No, they are not. Or either down.
The uplink station wurde aktiviert. Haltet sie.
Okay, now you're roll jumping good. Again, I don't know where you're using first person.
Der Feind ist hier. Achtung! Feindlicher Orbitalangriff!
That was a bad jetpack. I think you should have noticed that thermal improver before you rolled forward. So okay, it was a fair jump pack. And you can already see here that this small red point, which is making visible the more visible the thermal improver and the enemy grenades for you, are dropping down. And you can even hear the sound of it. But you still decide to roll forward and you die by it. I still don't get the point of first person. You should have been using your cycler here because your enemy is behind the squad shield, and with this like cycler rifle can go through the squad shield. That jetpack was unnecessary. Okay, I can see now I'm using the tactic of cycler and squad shield combo, that's good. Okay, miss that shot, doesn't matter, that happens sometimes. But actually it is a very bad position, because you are now safe in here, but it is just a matter of time that the health of the squad shield goes down, or the person who activated this squad shield activates another one, and this will disappear and you are completely out of cover and will be vulnerable for your enemies.
So,
but let's just say the squad shield will not disappear soon. So you go out from there, but you're still out of cover and you are completely vulnerable for your enemies, even if they are out of cover also. You could have gone back, you could have gone to the back of this uplink, that should be a good cover. Especially if you are seeing the red mark where are the shutting, where are the damage coming from. And again, you didn't spawn on your partner, I don't know why, you're wasting many time here. You go back to the same place. What I would have done in your place is either spawning on my partner. I went back too much. so... Okay, you die here. And you could have spawned on your partner, who is at the first uplink that you activated at the beginning of the match. And you could have flanked from behind your enemies, and you could have gotten many kills, in my opinion. But okay, you didn't spawn on him. What I would have done is jetpacking up here and go to the small hole on the left above the uplink, or go even farther and flank from the enemy back and flank the enemy from back. But you're going back to the same choke point like last time. Okay, that was a good jetpack. And a bad rapid fire. You didn't spawn on your partner again. Let's see it again. So, after 12 minutes of gameplay, you have 3500 points, 10 kills and 8 deaths. I wouldn't consider it as a good result. Oh, that was a nice shot. Okay, you are walking, that's good. And flanking him, that was nice. Your aim was really bad there. I mean, the cycler, finishing him off with the cycler was good. But before that, already here, when the guy appears, you should be able to move your aim pros to there, to him, and rapid fire like crazy, and even if you miss your shots, you just activate your cooling cell and continue firing. But you made only two bursts, and right after that you activated your cooling cell even though you were behind the cover. But the cycler shot was good. Okay, that's fine. Without trying to roll jump here, you could have just ran on wall here. And I don't know what you are doing here. I don't know why did you decide to go even back? Personally, I wouldn't be holding my smart racket if I'm on the same level of ground or even lower than my enemies are, rather than cycler. Because going for a direct hit with a smart racket is not a smart idea. And I don't know why are you standing here now. I still don't understand what you are doing here, because if you check the radar in 1 second, you can see no one is nearby. Okay, you are trying to give advices for your teammates, but if you do it, I rather would do that in the team chat, not in the all visible chat. I would especially put away my smart racket and pull out my E3 or at least my cycler out, because know you are facing your enemies when they are coming from the high ground or higher ground than you are, and if you really want to snipe them out basically with a smart racket, I would take with my head. Ah, yeah, like that, okay. I still don't understand what you are doing. Put away the racket, please. You should have killed that guy with the racket and you wasted your cycler, but okay, never mind, it will recharge quite soon. Okay, cycler is a good choice now. Missed the shot, doesn't matter. But that was a very bad aiming there, and like now also. I really didn't notice the enemy there. I mean, okay, you are focusing on that guy, you killed him. And already here you can see one grenade, one small red point is coming from this direction. So there must be someone from the enemy team, and you can even see him. But you don't pay attention. Still don't. And no. And now you are hearing, I guess, the gun shooting. Okay, at least you are now behind the cover. But you are not peeking. You cannot see anything. Okay, no, it's good, you can see. But why he fired with cycler when you should have just pull out your E3 and finish off the guy. Alright. That's not exactly what good players do. Just saying, you are completely standing still. If someone spots you with a sniper rifle, he will give you an easy headshot. Okay, you missed the shot, doesn't matter. Your rapid fire is really bad. Your aiming is not so good also. But you got the kill at least. You are aiming, you are looking for enemies here, but there is one here, but you cannot see him. If I were you, I would definitely move forward. If you check the radar, your enemies are far away. Okay, that was a nice shot. You are using Berserker trait, but if I notice it correctly, you mostly zoom in almost every time you are shooting, so it's not really a good choice for Berserker. And I guess you are trying to go to camp with the blaster cannon at the edge of the map. That's also not really what the good players usually do. Especially if you are, if you have the best weapon in the game and you are Berserker level 3. Okay, but fine, you are doing the objective, that's good. Or never mind. That ATST would need only one anti-vehicle racket to kill you, but looks like he doesn't care. Yeah, it really looks like he doesn't care about you. right, you basically had a smart idea by choosing this position for the blaster cannon, and you can go for the splash damage here. And let's see the final score. If you lost the game, okay, I don't care about that, especially not in Walker's Seoul. So you finished in 19 and 8, which is more than a 12.4 KD, I think. But if you compare your numbers to the other good players in the lobby, like Gmos or Page, they got 74 more than 3 times kill than you did, and less deaths than you did. So okay, the 19 kills in a 20 or 19 minutes gameplay isn't enough, in my opinion, for calling anyone a good player. Even if you are an objective player, the 6,300 points are also less, not enough. So in my opinion, even with this setup, you are not able to play good enough to be called a good player. Okay, so you have 1700 hours in the game, just like me, or maybe I have a little bit more, but you have 90,000 kills. I am going for 360,000, okay. Your KD is 0.18, that's also not so impressive. And the points, your score is also not really high, neither your win-lose ratio. But all I can say after this, keep accusating legit players and have fun in the game. At least it will look nice for you if you will not be able to play good. Thank you for watching, see you later guys.